We tend to take the work and kind of 50-50 split it. You know, we work faster than most. I think it's we feel good about the fact that there's two minds working for one direction, and you know, it works pretty well.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, it's just having somebody else that has the same thought process as you, same taste as you.
A clone, basically.
Yeah, yeah. That's what it comes down to.
Shawn brought a level of energy and passion and support to this that was just so helpful. He's like our big brother, to be honest. We have a great dynamic with him. He's super experienced and he just loves to please an audience and you know, helps us on that journey as well.
Yeah. Very helpful.
We'd be remiss to not talk about the sci-fi aspects of the movie, because they obviously, you know, are super important. You know, this boy finds something that is not from this world, and he has this very close relationship with it, a connection to it, if you will. And that weapon that it ultimately becomes, you know, takes him on this journey that it really takes him down a bad road at times, and you know, makes him question sort of what kind of man does he want to be.
Yeah, and it puts choices in front of him. You know, do I want to be good? Do I want to be bad? It's as simple as that. And I think it's about following that character and figuring out where he stands in the world.
And there's an aspect of loss of innocence there. It's like this 14-year-old boy taken down a bad road and shown very adult-themed things throughout the movie and throughout his journey, and ultimately at the end he has to question, you know, is this how I want to be, you know, as a man? And his father, his brother, he has these male archetypes in his life, and it's like he's looking at all of that and saying, what do I want to become? That's important. There was something really fun to us about retelling the classic Sword in the Stone fable and doing a modern sort of retelling of it. You know, about a boy that's lost his parents and is drawn to something that only he can hold and wield.
Right.
And that is the sci-fi futuristic version of what a broadsword was back in the day, you know, which probably was quite a controversial image of a child holding a sword. And we now have a young 14-year-old boy holding an alien weapon.